I'm Sam Hollis from Sam Hollis Web Design. I'm going to talk to you today about using Moosend to send automatic emails. So Moosend is an email marketing piece of software. I've got some other videos on here that will give you a basic tour of Moosend, show you to add subscribers, show you how to make a newsletter. This one is about sending automated emails. So they're emails that are triggered by a particular event. It might be something in your shop or on your website or somebody signing up to a mailing list and emails that are automatically triggered because of this. So I'll take you through that now. So if we go into Moosend, you can see there's a menu on the left and we want to go to automations, where we are now. And from automations, we click on create new automation. So what's this for? We're going to imagine that we've got a website. We've got a form on it, and I'm going to do a video shortly about how to make a form on a website. When somebody fills it in, they're added to a mailing list. Or it could be that you manually add them to a mailing list, or they're added by another way. But the key is they're added to a mailing list, and being added to that mailing list is going to be a trigger to send them an email or a series of emails. So you can see, once you're on start new animation, we can select the type of automation we want. You can see we've got a big list of automations here. It might be one if someone's abandoned a cart, or if somebody's got a birthday and another date of birth. It could be onboarding, all sorts of options, especially if you link to a shop, you can do all sorts here. Even it can link to the weather. But we're going to do our own. So we're going to do create custom animation. So we will click there so we can do our own. So it's called new automation, so we will change that right now. So that will be then, I'll call this just test now. When you change the name, click save automation. If you just click enter, you lose it, which is really easy to do. So first thing is the trigger. So we click on select your trigger. So what is going to make this series of automated emails start? Why are they going to start? So we said for us, it's going to be that somebody is added to a particular mailing list. You have to be careful in here. So these are triggered. For example, this when someone opens any campaign. That means when someone opens a single one of your newsletters, this will trigger this event to happen. Okay. But sometimes it's specific. So that when someone opens any campaign, this is when someone clicks on link in a specific campaign. So you can be general or specific. There's all sorts of triggers here about people clicking links, people subscribing to lists. So this is when someone subscribes to any list. We don't want that. We want when somebody subscribes to a particular list. The amount of options here is quite big. So we want when somebody subscribes to a particular list. A specific list, but yeah, there's all sorts of options that might trigger your automated emails. So we'll click that one. That's what we want. And then we have to choose which of the mailing lists we're going to use. Test mailing list. It is that we want to trigger this. So when somebody is added to the test mailing list, then this set of emails will be triggered. If they are there already, they will not receive these emails. This email is only triggered if somebody is added new to that list after we've made this live. You have to be really clear so it doesn't go to people who are already on the list. So somebody fills in the form on the website that added to the list. What do we want to happen next? So we've got a little plus, we'll click on that. What's the next step? We've got a couple of choices. We've got action, so something happens, like send an email, send you a notice, send a message to Slack, all sorts of options, subscribe them to another list, trigger another automation, all sorts of things. And then the other option is a control step. So I'm going to start with a control step. So we've got to wait for a time period or a weather, or split the flow if you want to test 50-50. You know, some people getting one email, some the other, see which works best. I'm going to go for wait a time interval, and I'm going to just make it 30 minutes. Okay, so 30 minutes. You can change this to minutes, hours, days, months. I'm going to do 30 minutes. So the idea is when somebody fills in this form, they don't instantly get an email. They get one 30 minutes later. It just makes it look like maybe somebody has sent it personally rather than it's quite so automated. It's quite a nice little thing to do. So we'll just let that load up. It's just going into place now. It can be a little bit slow. You can see the red bar going across the top, which means it should be getting there. Hopefully. Once we've got that, we can then start to send an email. I'll try and save that again. It's obviously not quite managing. Once we've done that, we can add an email, and there's several different types of emails we can add. Here we go. So we've got wait for 30 minutes, then we'll do another plus. Okay, this time we want an action and we want to send an email campaign. Okay, so we'll click on there. So the title of your email says is maybe, you know, saying welcome to my mailing list. If they get a free download, it's talking about that. So I'm just going to say welcome. You obviously need to spend some time crafting what your titles are and stuff. Sent by me, that person has to be part of the Moosend setup. There's two options for your email then. On the left, we've got create new content, and you can write a text-based email. You can add in some pictures. You can see here bullet points and numbers and some links, and change the colors a bit, but it's a sort of standard text email, nothing too exciting. Okay, the advantage of that is it looks quite personal. It looks like you've just sent them an email personally. You can go to the other side and create content from campaign, and we can go into the campaign's designer and use the all singing and dancing designer we can use when we normally send newsletters. Okay, and I've got another video. I'm not going to go into that now because I've got another video on how that works. The advantage of that is you can make it much more engaging. We can use colour, we can use big buttons. The disadvantage is it's clearly automated mass email, while as the other one looks a bit more personal, like somebody's just sent it to them. Okay. The other option down here is fetch a campaign's content. So you do have the option in here that if you've already written a newsletter, you might just want to drag it in and send it, and you can click on there to do that. But we're not going to use this side. As I say, there's a whole video showing you how to use the designer. We're just going to use the plain text email. So I'm just going to say hello. Welcome to my campaign from Sam. And then you can change the font. There's a few options with fonts. There's only one or two. You don't want to go too fancy with your fonts, otherwise it's not always displayed. You can add links. So let's say as well, if we change that, let's say we want to add a link there. So we click on there and we can add a link. So we'll go to link it to my blog, to blog.com. So we can add a link. You see there's the words and there's the blog. So you can see that's a link, and you can click the little arrow to test it. And I might want to personalize it, so maybe I want to say hello and then the name of the person on the list. So on the far right here, I've got that little hash, and there's all sorts of links and things you can add. So there's all sorts of, and one of them, yeah, account, address, company, recipient name. So when I do that, then the person's name will go in that box, so it will go personally to them. Then all I need to do is leave everything else as it is and click save. I've now got a automated campaign here where somebody goes to a mailing list, it triggers it, it waits 30 minutes, it sends them an email. Maybe I want to do a couple of things. Maybe first of all, I want just to drop an email to myself so I know when I've gained people. I can just say a message there, then ping me. So that then, so it goes, you've gained a new subscriber, so you will get that message every time somebody subscribes, so you just know who's added to your mailing list. If you're gaining lots of people, you might want to move it because it'll annoy you, but it can be quite nice. Then maybe you actually want to send them a follow email, so let's do wait a specific time interval, and we'll say maybe we'll wait for 7 days. We'll give them a week, 7 days, save. So we'll give them a little bit of time. And after 7 days, we want to email them again. So we can do plus, and this time we want an action. We want to send them an email campaign. And again, we give them a subject. Hello again. And it works just the same as before. We can do the from a campaign there. We can write the text in the box here. And when that's done, we go down to the bottom and we click save. Campaign's done. So if we left it like that, it would just finish, and that's fine. People can just drop out the bottom and they're finished. You can, if you want, make other things happen. So you could then add that they join another mailing list, or that we trigger another automation so that then they join another automation. You can do all sorts of things at the end. So the next thing then is to make it live. So we let's have a look and find the make it live button. I can't seem to find the make it live button because it looks to me like it's ready. Yep, test one people. Okay, so it's all ready, so we should be good to go. So let's have a look. Let's go back to our automations list, and our automation should be here. I'll give it a second, it should load up at the top, our test automation. And then we can make it live. It's good to go. Once it's live, what I strongly suggest, here we go. So it says it's incomplete, so it won't let us make it live. So we'll click on here and see why it thinks it's incomplete. So we've got okay, we've got a description, we've got a name. It says one task pending. Ah, sender is empty and hello again. So I forgot on the last email to add a sender. So it's not letting us make it go live because it doesn't say who sent it. So there we go, Sam Hollis. That can be sent now. We can save that. So this automation is currently stopped. We click that and we can make it live. This is now active. So if anybody is added to this list, test mailing list, this will happen. So what I strongly suggest is you add yourself. You can then see the test in action, see it as it happens, check your emails work, and then do it live with customers. A couple of things you can do. One, if you're testing it, you can obviously change this 7 days to 7 minutes, but don't forget to change it back because you don't want to wait a week while you're testing it. The other thing is, if you have people in this mailing list, so maybe 3 days ago somebody triggered this, so it's waited 30 minutes, it sent them the welcome email, and they're now in this, and it's pinged you, and they're now in the wait for 7 days, and they're 3 days in. Okay, you have to be very careful. If you turn this off and it stays off for more than about 2 minutes, anybody in this automation will be lost, and anyone who's waiting for 7 days will disappear from the list and won't get the last email. So you must keep these live. Okay, it's really easy to turn them off. If I edit something, so let's say I want to go in here and edit it, Moosend normally, after I've done editing, I didn't actually change that one. Moosend normally, after you've done some editing, I'm going to change that to hello again, Fred, will turn the automation off. And then you've got to be really careful, because if it stays off for too long, there we go, because I've made a change, it's turned it off. That is off for 2 minutes. You lose everybody in the automation, so you need to be really careful that it stays live. And if it does get turned off, it's turned on straight away again. Okay, so that explains to you how to make an automated sequence of emails to send to people. We've talked about how to trigger it, we've talked about what emails to send, and you could add as many as you like to that list and then make them send other ones. You can make them as long, short, complex, or simple as you like. But that is a basic run through. I hope that has been useful to you. I'm Sam Hollis from Sam Hollis Web Design.